All right, just a client who has an iguana and a tortoise and a few other nice little exotic creatures. While we were in there that one day, he goes, "What do you do about a fish that just won't go to the bottom?" And of course, as you guys can tell, this here is a betta. If you're looking right there, you can actually see where part of the air bladder is about to rupture to the outside of the fish. So our mission here is to, one, keep that from rupturing and too large a hole that this fish can't heal. And two, let's get a sample of what's in there, put that under a microscope, and see if we can get an answer. Unfortunately, I've not found a way to bring the microscope to the house, so we'll get our sample, and I'll take that back with me, and I'll look at that under the microscope there. Anyway, so this guy's obviously got some issues. Right now, as long as this particular stick does not kill him, we should actually get some answers and know where things are going to go. Like I was telling you a second ago, Dad, that air bladder is not its usual spot. Okay, ordinarily, I would just try to pinpoint and use my transilluminator to find out where the air bladder was, and then from there, you know, make the next decision as to where to stick that needle. But really, we don't have any choice, and it's not in its normal place. So this is not the simple case I thought it was going to be. Okay, but at the same time, this does need to be done. Okay. All right, so I'm going to rinse off my gloves in just a second, catch this guy up, do the deed, and then we'll set this guy back down there, and hopefully all will be well. All right, buddy. Hang on. Get an idea of just the scale here. That is the scale. Oh, well, well, hold still just a little bit longer. And that is the size of our sample. Well, he's down.
Oh, you're kidding me. Oh, he hadn't been down in months. Oh, is he just going under a rock to sit? Oh, he sure is. Look at that. Oh my gosh, Dr. Askew. So did it just all something come out when you poked it? Oh my gosh, you got several...
Well, no, it's just mostly just suction and air, but there's a little bit of a wet sample in there, so I'll have something for the microscope.
Okay. Oh my gosh.
Here he is.
Oh, wow. Oh, rest, little fella. Just rest. I know he's exhausted. It had to be done. It was excruciating watching the air bladder look like it was tearing through his skin and coming out. And I've been doing daily water changes almost with aquarium salts that are supposed to help reheal. And I've been like trying to fight this for so long. And I mean, it's just been a very long, excruciating death. Something, you know, one way or the other needed to happen. I'm so glad. I wanted to poke it myself several times, but I didn't know if that was a thing to do.
Well, you know, had you done this and missed it, you know, then that could have caused some serious issues.
Exactly. And then I'd have had to live with myself.
And then you still wouldn't have a sample to work with or a way to work with that sample.
I wouldn't know what kind of anything to use. So.
So is there a chance it'll just refill with air and he'll float back to the top again?
There is definitely a chance it'll refill with air. Uh-huh. The mechanism with which the air gets into the air bladder is actually pretty complicated. I mean, it's really cool, but I won't go into the physiology of it right now. But my point is it's really cool. Good news is he is breathing right now pretty well, just to make sure. He's like, dude, you put a needle in my body. That's just screwed up.
Mild shock from just having not been able to swim down for, I mean, he's been in that sea shape, I mean, since like March. Stops asking what to do. I have just.
So right there is, let me get the camera to focus. Nope, it's not going to do it. That's as good as it gets. Anyway, right there is the lesion. We're actually stuck the needle. And there's our buddy breathing. He's like, dude, I'm stressed. But at least I'm on the bottom. And now being on the bottom might not be the best thing for him either, because these guys do need to be at the surface for a little bit. The good news is he can swim there. He's not stuck there, but he can still swim there.
I do have the filter set up. It's usually on. Mm-hmm. It just does like a trickle through that. Do you think that would help to keep the water oxygenated? Do they not have... Maybe they don't have to make as many trips to the surface if the water is like...
If the water is oxygenated, it definitely makes his job of breathing a little bit easier. Well, I'll tell you, I'm really a fan of under gravel filters. Uh-huh. Okay? I think they do awesome. The fact that this is where they swim, okay, here in the middle area. Still breathing.
This is what they do when they're in shock. So I imagine that it probably was really painful to have that thing pricked, you know?
Well, the good news is it went through less tissue than I was anticipating, so.
And just to have that deflation occur in your body has gotta be